In this section, I'll be covering the basics of exporting your completed designs. So let's say you've finished one and it's this design here and you want to export it. So you simply head up to File and Export. This pop-up box will appear and then you decide which file format you want to export it as. Now there are many here, but some of the most common ones are PNG, usually good for designs that might have transparent properties in it. We've got JPEG as well, very small, all of these used on social media. And then you've got file types that can include like vector items in them, like PDF, SVG, EPS. You've even got PSD there, which is a Photoshop file type, but you decide the one you want. You can just hit JPEG if you want. And then here we have the options for JPEG. It's telling us our document size, the preset, best quality, high quality, etc. And then it's asking, do you want the whole document? And it's only showing this option. We'll come back to this, but I just want to show you the first export. And then this one here, don't export layers hidden by export persona. So if you had layers there that are hidden, it wouldn't export them if you click that. And basically every time you press something, it will show you the preview of what's going to be exported. And then it goes down into more advanced options. And then when you're ready, you can just press export and decide where you want to export it. Okay, let me press cancel here, and I'll just show you what happens if I select both of these shapes, and now I go up to File and Export, and I'll switch over to PNG, and then we go down to Area, and remember I said about whole document, I'll come back to it. Well, now that I've just selected those shapes, it's given me more options. So instead of the whole document being exported, I could select Selection Area Only, and it shows me just what I selected. The one in the background there. But what if I wanted it to be transparent in the background, like all the white part? Well, I just select selection only. And you see we have this checkerboard in the background, which means it's going to be transparent there. Maybe good for if you're going to be printing stickers. And then you can go ahead and press export. So that's the basics of exporting. If you were using artboards, also this area would show artboard 1, artboard 2, etc. And if you'd selected anything like I have here, it would also show you these other options here. So when you're ready, you just press export and you have your file.